previous videos, we have learned about the life processes, how do organisms reproduce, and heredity chapter. Now today we will complete over, we will start over new chapter and the last chapter of our biology course of class 10, which is our environment. What is the meaning of environment? This environment word comes from French, which meaning is surrounding. So whatever the things is which our surrounding, this is called environment. If we look forward to the components of environment, there are three major components: physical surrounding, living organism, and climate factor. Obviously, when we look in our surrounding, what are the physical things are present in our environment? Like air, water, land, these all are the physical surrounding, what we can see in our surrounding. Living organism, in environment, whatever the living organisms are present, like plants, animals, humans, even microorganisms, fungi, decomposers, bacteria and fungi, these all are living organisms which play very important role to maintain our ecosystem. So in this living organism, all the living organisms comes, and last is climatic factor. In our environment, so many climate factors like rainfall, pressure, temperature, humidity, sunlight, so many climate factors which are going to affect our environment. So if we see the major components of our environment, there are three main parts: physical surrounding and air, water and all, and in living organism, plants, animals, microorganisms, humans, fungi, bacteria and all, this comes in this category. And last is climate factor: sunlight, wind speed, temperature, pressure, all the climate factors which are going to affect our environment. Now, after that, we will discuss about ecosystem. As I just now told you that the living and all the physical things are both are interacting to each other. So, the structural and functional unit of biosphere, which comprising the living and non-living organisms, which comprising living and non-living organisms and interact and exchange the material. So, both are going to interact and exchanging the material, which is called ecosystem. Now, if we discuss about the types of ecosystem, there are two types of ecosystem. One is artificial ecosystem, and second is natural ecosystem. Artificial ecosystem means, you know, the ecosystem which is created by human efforts, and natural ecosystem, the ecosystem which is present in our nature. There the human efforts are not required. So if you see, in what type of artificial or human effort used ecosystems are there, you can say like garden, and a garden is a total is created by human efforts. Nurseries, park, these all are like aquarium, and the aquarium where you keep these fishes and plants and all, this is created by human efforts. So in artificial ecosystems, some examples like aquarium, garden, nurseries, even the crop field where the farmers grow the crop, this is also one of example of artificial ecosystem. Now natural ecosystem, in nature the ecosystem which are present, it is again further divided in two parts. We can say like aquatic natural ecosystem and terrestrial ecosystem. In aquatic ecosystem, like similar examples like ponds in nature, like ponds, river, oceans, this all comes in this category. And in terrestrial, like grassland, forest, and desert, these are the terrestrial natural ecosystem. So what we have discussed, in ecosystem there are two main types: artificial, where the human efforts are required, like examples garden, crop field, nurseries, park and all. And in natural ecosystem, further divide in two parts which is present in our nature, like aquatic, ocean, river, ponds and all, and in terrestrial, grassland, desert, grassland, deserts and all. So these are the types of ecosystem. Now we will discuss about the components of ecosystem. What are the components? What are the components or what are the things which is required to make a complete ecosystem? So let's discuss what the components of ecosystem. There are two main components of ecosystem: abiotic and biotic components. Abiotic, in which all the non-living farm. In biotic components, producers, consumers, and decomposers are categorized. Now, here a very important question for your board purpose also, that explain all the biotic factors of components of ecosystem in detail. Explain all the biotic components in detail. So, what are three biotic components? Producers, consumers, and decomposers. So, let's discuss one by one all these components. First is producers. In producers, always one of examples comes, which is green plants and the green trees, green grass. Okay. So, what are producers which make their food by the process of photosynthesis? So, autotrophic nutrient organisms always categorize as a producers. Second is consumers. Consumers are always heterotrophic. It is further categorized as herbivorous, carnivorous, omnivorous, and parasitic. Herbivorous, which used to eat plants but depend on others. That's why it is called as a heterotrophic. These are consumers. Carnivorous, which used to eat animal fleshes. Okay, but these are carnivorous. And omnivorous, which used to eat plants and animal flesh both. And parasitic, which depend on other organisms for completely or partially for the food, and are completely or partially for the food on the host. These are known as a parasite. So consumer further divide into herbivorous, which used to eat plants, carnivorous, which used to eat animal fleshes, and omnivorous, which used to eat plants and animal fleshes both. Parasitic, which depend on other completely or partially on the host for the food, are known as parasite. So these are the consumers. Here you can see primary, secondary, tertiary, quaternary consumers. So what is the meaning of this? So like if producer, and a producer means what? Plants. And if the plant is eaten by rat, this rat is eaten by snake, and this snake is eaten by eagle. Okay, if we look forward to this, so if there is a plant, so it is a producer, and this full category is a carnivorous. These all are carnivorous. Depend on others for the food, but these are also consumers. So the rat is used to eat plants. So this is a herbivorous and it is a first consumer. It is herbivorous, but it is a first consumer. Now this rat is eaten by snake, so it is a secondary consumer. This snake is eaten by eagle, so it is a third, tertiary consumer. So this way, primary consumer, secondary consumer, tertiary consumer, quaternary consumer, but all are consumers, all are heterotrophs, so which is categorized in this. Okay, so consumers can be primary, secondary, tertiary, and quaternary. Now last is decomposers. Now decomposers, which is the organism which used to eat dead decaying plants and animals. That means these are saprophytic always. What are the examples? Like fungi and bacteria. Okay, so in this, examples are fungi and bacteria. These are always saprophytic. What is saprophytic? Organism which depend on food for the dead decaying plants and animals. Here we can see decomposers. Decomposers are helping to clean our earth, helping to clean our environment. These are like a cleaning agent. How? When the plants and animals die, okay, what happens? They are, after some time, it completely decompose. They mix in the soil, okay, which increase the fertility. So, indirectly, this saprophytic cleaning the environment, decomposing these plants and animals and cleaning our environment. So, we can say decomposer are also cleaning agent. These decomposers are also cleaning agent. So, here we discuss about components of ecosystem, abiotic, physical factor, inorganic and organic. In biotic, we have discussed producers, consumers and decomposers. In detailed answer, you will explain about this all the terms. Herbivorous, carnivorous, omnivorous and parasitic. Even you write about the consumers, primary, secondary, tertiary consumers. And decomposers, which is a cleaning agent. These are the saprophytes, which depend on dead decaying plants and animals. Here one more separate question will ask from this paragraph, that write any two role of decomposers in our environment. Okay, what are the role of decomposers in our environment? So what you can write, the first thing is that it is a cleaning agent. It's cleaning, it helps to clean the environment while decomposing the dead plants and animals. First role. Second role, while after decomposing, it converts into humus. know our today's video. What are the topics we have discussed? First, we discussed about the definition of environment. Then we have discussed about the components of environment: physical factors, living organisms, and climatic factor. Then we have discussed about the definition of ecosystem and types of ecosystem. There are two types of ecosystem: artificial and natural. If natural ecosystem further divided into two types: aquatic and terrestrial. And last, we have discussed about the components of ecosystem: abiotic and biotic. In abiotic, physical factors, inorganic and organic substances, and biotic factor, producers, consumers, and decomposers. And here I told you it's a very important detailed question. Explain all the biotic factors of ecosystem in detail. So producers, you have to explain about the photosynthesis and autotrophic. Consumers, all this definition: herbivorous, carnivorous, omnivorous, and parasitic. And decomposers, here you have to explain about the saprophytes and the role of decomposers.